Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this channel we provide the in-depth knowledge of computer programming languages which differentiate you with others. From last two classes we are discussing something known as function. In the same series today we will discuss something known as communication between the functions. Now try to concentrate, this is very important topic. Here we will learn something known as call by value, how two functions communicate, called function and the calling function. Till now functions are not so flexible. We call them, they do the specific task, like mechanic function who always service our motorbike. We have already discussed, whenever we want to perform a specific task we call that function, like we are having mechanic, carpenter and plumber. We call them, they do the specific task, like mechanic function who always service our motorbike. It would be nice to have little more control over the function, what function do. In the same way, it would be nice to tell the mechanic that also change the engine oil with motorbike service. Means sometimes there may be a chance you have to give the additional information to the function, like in the example of mechanic, he also changed the engine oil. In short, we want to communicate with the mechanic, or we want to communicate between the calling function and the called function. Now what is calling function, what is called function, that we have already discussed in the last class. The mechanism used to convey information from the calling function to the called function is the argument or parameters. What we have learned, the mechanism used to convey information from the calling function to the called function is the argument or the parameters. Unknowingly we have already using from the first class in printf and scanf. Now what we are seeing, anything between the parentheses of the function is known as argument. What we are learning here, anything between the parentheses of the function, anything between the parentheses of the function is known as argument. Here what we are writing, printf hello. So what is hello here? Hello is an argument or parameter. In scanf, %i end of a, here we are passing two arguments. Anything between the parentheses of the function, what we have written, anything between the parentheses of the function is known as argument. Now see, here we are having two things. First, the mechanism used to convey information from the calling function to the called function is nothing but an argument or parameters. Unknowingly we have already using from the first class when we start learning C in printf and scanf. What we are doing, we are calling a printf function and we are passing this hello. What is hello here? Hello is an argument. In scanf, %i end of a, %i and end of a are what? These are nothing but the arguments. So anything between the parentheses of the function, agar wo function hoga to parenthesis hoga hi hoga. Why? Because how C identifies a function? A non keyword followed by a pair of parentheses is a फंक्शन. तो पैरेंथेसिस के बीच में जो कुछ भी होगा, एनीथिंग बिटवीन द पैरेंथेसिस ऑफ द फंक्शन, इट मे बी कांस्टेंट, इट मे बी वेरिएबल, इट मे बी एक्सप्रेशन, दैट वी विल सी इन फर्दर क्लासेस. एनीथिंग बिटवीन द पैरेंथेसिस ऑफ द फंक्शन इज नोन एज आर्गुमेंट. नेक्स्ट, आर्गुमेंट इज यूज्ड टू पास सम वैल्यू फ्रॉम द कॉलिंग फंक्शन टू द कॉल्ड फंक्शन. व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस आर्गुमेंट्स? Arguments are used to pass some value from the calling function to the called function. In case of user and mechanic, user is what? User is a calling function and mechanic is a called function. Now if you want to pass some value from the user to mechanic, you have to speak it out. Same thing, how functions communicate with the help of arguments. Argument is used to pass some values from the calling function to the called function. Means agar calling function se agar called function mein kuch aapko pass karna hai, how we can pass? With the help of arguments. तो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स. फर्स्ट वन इज एक्चुअल आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड सेकेंड वन इज फॉर्मल आर्ग्यूमेंट. लिसन केयरफुली, वी हैव गोइंग थ्रू एन नंबर ऑफ टर्मोलॉजीज. ट्राई टू रिमेंबर ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. फर्स्ट वी हैव डन द मैकेनिज्म यूज टू कन्वे इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द कॉलिंग फंक्शन टू द कॉल फंक्शन इज नथिंग बट एन आर्ग्यूमेंट्स. वट आर आर्ग्यूमेंट्स? एनीथिंग बिटवीन द पैरेंथिसिस ऑफ द फंक्शन आर नोन एज आर्ग्यूमेंट्स. आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर यूज टू पास सम वैल्यू फ्रॉम द कॉलिंग फंक्शन टू द कॉल्ड फंक्शन. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट. फर्स्ट वन इज एक्चुअल आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड सेकेंड वन इज फॉर्मल आर्ग्यूमेंट. Now, actual argument are those which are given at the time of function call. What are actual arguments? Actual arguments are those which are given at the time of function call, and formal argument are those which are given at the time of function definition. We have already gone through function prototype, function call and function definition. Means at the time of function call, if we are passing some values between the parentheses, so those arguments are known as actual arguments, and that arguments are passed to the called function. And in the definition, if we are writing any variables inside the parentheses of the function, that are known as formal argument. There are two ways through which we can pass these arguments from the calling function to the called function. Today we will discuss something known as call by value, and second is call by reference. Call by reference, we have to learn something known as pointers, which is very, very, very interesting and important topic in C language that we are trying to cover in the further classes. Today we will cover something known as call by value. In call by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. What we have written? In call by value, the copy of the actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Now let's try to learn, try to understand this concept using one example. Here what we are writing, hash include stdio.h. What is stdio.h? This is an header file that will be included. Why we have to include this file? Because the definition of the printf, scanf, n number of functions are defined in this header file. Not definition, basically the prototype of printf and scanf are declared in this header file, and definition is defined in some other compiled form files. Now what we are writing, int calsum int comma int. What is this? This is known as function prototype. What is function prototype? It's a declaration which defines the return type and the argument of the function. So what we are writing, int calsum int comma int. What does it mean? Calsum is a user defined function. Why we are saying that calsum is a user defined function? Because the definition of the calsum function is defined by the user. So what we are saying, calsum is a user defined function which receives two integer value and it returns one integer value. Then in void main, what is main? Main is a user defined function. Program always start executing from the opening brace of main and terminates with the closing brace of main. Now here main is what? Main becomes calling function, and printf, scanf, calsum, printf, this all are what? This all are called function. Why? Because main is calling all this function. What are these? These are function calls. We are making a call to the printf function. Now let's see one by one. Int a comma b comma sum. What is a b sum? These are the variables of type integer. Then we are making a function called printf enter two numbers. We are passing this enter two numbers to the printf definition. It will display this message. Then scanf percentage I end of a comma end of b. Now what is percentage I here? Percentage I is known as format specifier. Why we have to specify a format specifier in scanf? Because scanf can scan n number of values from the keyboard, n number of values as well as n number of types also. Now in which format you want to scan the value, you have to specify with the help of format specifier. So what we are saying, scan the value in integer format. F stands for format. Scan the value in integer format and store at this address. And is what? It's an address operator. Same thing, scan the value in integer format and store at this address. The two integer value will be scanned from the keyboard. Let's take an example, 4 and 5. Two values are scanned from the user. Then we are making sum is equal to calsum a comma b. Now what is this? Here we are making a function call known as calsum. Why? Because we have already learned any function name followed by a parenthesis and a semicolon, it becomes what? It becomes function call. So we are making a call to the calsum function and we are passing some value to the called function. Here a and b is what? These are arguments. Why these are arguments? Because what we have learned, anything between the parentheses of the function is argument. Here a and b are what? Argument. Again there are two types of argument. First one is actual and second one is formal. Here a and b are what? These are actual arguments. Why? Because the arguments given at the time of function call, the arguments given at the time of function call are known as actual arguments. These arguments can be passed using call by value or call by reference. So this is an example of call by value. Now what happens in call by value? The copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Means the copy of A will be passed and it will be received in X, and the copy of B will be passed and received in Y. Now what is X and Y? X and Y are nothing but arguments. Which type of arguments? Formal arguments. Why these are arguments? Anything between the parentheses of the functions are known as arguments, and the arguments given at the time of definition becomes formal arguments. So here we are passing, the copy of A is passed in X and the copy of B is passed in Y. This is an example of call by value. What happens in call by value? The copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. In A what we are having? We are having 4. 4 will be passed in X. In B what we are having? 5. 5 will be passed in Y. Any doubt here? No. Let's proceed further. Now this X is having what? 4. And this Y is having what? 5. Now in the definition of the calsum function, we are having a local variable called int d. D is equal to x plus y, return d. Now if we are passing some value from the calling function to the called function, we can pass using arguments. But if you want to return some value from the called function to the calling function, we have to use a keyword called return. Is return is a function? It is looking like a function, but it is not a function. Why? Because return is a keyword. Or function ki definition humne kya padhi hai? A non-keyword followed by a pair of parentheses is a function. But return is a keyword. What is return? Return is a keyword which is used to return some value from the called function to the calling function. Means calling function se agar called function mein kuch value pass karna hai, that can be passed with the help of arguments. और अगर called function से calling function में कोई value return करना है, that can be written using return keyword. What is return? Return is a keyword. What is keyword? Keyword is a word whose meaning is already defined in the machine. Okay, fine. So in main function we are scanning two values with the help of calsum function. This is function call. We are passing a and b. The copy of A will be passed in X and the copy of B will be passed in Y. In A we are having 4, in B we are having 5. That will come down to the function definition, int d. D is equal to x plus y. X plus y is what? X is 4, y is 5. 5 plus 4, 9, return d. Return d means we are returning 9. If we are returning, so we have to receive somewhere. In sum we are receiving that 9. then printf percentage sum is percentage I sum. The output will be what? Output of this program will be 9. Here we are passing 4 and 5. This is call by value. In call by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Go through this program. If any doubt, you can ask me. Int calsum int comma int, this is what? This is a function declaration. Then void main int a comma b comma sum, printf enter two numbers, scanf percentage I and of a comma and of b, sum is equal to calsum a comma b. Now calsum is what? It's a user defined function. This is what? This is function call. What is a and b? A and b are actual arguments. What is a and b? A and b are arguments. Anything between the parentheses of the functions are arguments. Why we are using arguments? Arguments are used to pass some value from the calling function to the called function. It used to communicate between the function. So here a and b are what? A and b are actual arguments. These arguments can be passed in two ways. First one is by value and second one is by reference. For learning by reference, we have to learn something known as pointers that we are planning in future. Today we are learning by value. Now what happens in by value? In by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Here a and b are actual argument, whereas x and y are formal arguments. This is what? This is function definition and this is function call. The copy of a will be passed in x and the copy of b will be passed in y. Int d, d is equal to x plus y, return d, d will be returned and collected in some variable, printf sum per is percentage I sum, output will be 9. So this is a two-way communication. We are passing two values from the calling function to the called function, and after manipulating that value, the called function is returning one value to the calling function. Okay, fine. Now let's see some tips. The number, order and type of the actual and the formal arguments are always same. What does it mean? Means the number, order and type. Number means if we are passing two arguments from the calling function, we have to receive two arguments. If we are passing three, we have to receive in three. If we are passing four, we have to passing four. The number means 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Order means if A is integer, B is float. So X must be integer and Y must be float. In this example, we are having both the values as integer, but we can pass any data type. The number, order and type. Type means if we are passing an integer, we have to receive in an integer variable. If we are passing a float, we have to receive in a float variable. Same in the case of return also. If we are returning an integer value, we have to receive an integer variable. If we are returning a float value, we have to return in a float variable. Receive in a float variable. Return is a keyword which takes control back to the calling function with value or without value explicitly. Now what is return? Return is a keyword. What is keyword? Keyword is a word whose meaning is already defined to the machine. It takes control back to the calling function with value or without value explicitly. Why we are saying explicitly? Now see, what happens whenever we make a function call, the control comes to the definition of the function, and after executing all the statements, as it encounters the closing brace of the called function, the control goes back to the same statement from where the function call is made. That we have already discussed in previous classes. Here, what we are writing, return is a keyword which takes control back to the calling function with value or without value explicitly. Means now the control is not reaching to the closing brace, because as it encounters the return, the control goes back from this return function to the calling, from this return keyword back to the calling function. So it will not encounter. Means if I write here printf hello, will it execute? Now as you will try to compile this program, you will get an error. What error? This code has no effect. Why compiler says like this? This code has no effect because as it encounters the return keyword, the control will goes back to the calling function without executing printf hello. Okay, any doubt you can ask me, otherwise we will move further. Return is an keyword which takes control back to the calling function with value or without value. With value, here we are with value. We can write just return also. It will only return the control, but it will not return any value. But we are receiving, so we have to write int d here. Return is used to return some value from the called function to the calling function, and argument is used to pass some value from the calling function to the called function. So with the help of return keyword, we are returning some value from the called function to the calling function, and with the help of arguments, we can pass some value from the calling function to the called function. It's a two-way communication. We can pass n number of values from the calling function to the called function, but we can return only one value from the called function to the calling function. What does it mean? We can pass n number of values from the calling function to the called function, but we can return only one value from the called function. No language in this world can return more than one value from a function. It can receive n number of values, but it will not return it will not return more than one value from a function. I think this is enough for today. Go through every slide of this class very thoroughly, because function जैसा C में है वैसा C++ में है, वैसा Java में है, जैसा Python में है, सिर्फ क्या change होता है? Terminology. Only change, what change happens? The terminology. If C says functions, C++ says function, but Java says what? Method. But it is one or the same thing. So try to concentrate this function chapter very thoroughly, because it is very, very, very important chapter. Mechanism used to convey information from the calling function to the called functions are known as arguments, then parentheses, then argument, actual argument, formal argument, then call by value, call by reference. For call by reference, we have to learn something known as pointers that we are planning to teach in the further classes. Then this is an example of call by value. In call by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Return is a keyword whose meaning is already defined to the machine, and it takes the control back to the calling function explicitly. Fine. Thank you very much. If you are having any doubts, you can comment me. I will try to reply your answer within 24 hours. I think you are able to understand today's class. If any doubt, you can comment. Thank you. Thank you very much. Good night.